How much weight can you lift on the different planets? Imagine lifting a motorcycle with one hand, or manage to jump a height of 32 feet or 10 meters only with the strength of your legs. Although they seem like abilities worthy of a superhero, on other planets in the solar system, all these great feats would be possible for humans. Do you want to know how? Let's start. In our daily lives, we are used to lifting things and carrying them from one place to another. We move a chair to sit, lift objects and take them elsewhere, and even move with our feet. Sometimes we run into the difficult task of having to lift weighty objects like the furniture in the house, and wonder if there would not be an easier way to do it. Obviously, there are easier ways to move a piece of furniture than just using our strength, but what if we could lift anything with our strength alone, without the need to use cranes, ropes, or any other tool? A healthy, untrained adult can lift between 44 and 66 pounds, or 20 to 30 kilograms, without trying too hard. But what if a human tried to lift that same weight on the moon? The moon is the only natural satellite of our planet. It's smaller, therefore it has less mass, and because of that, its gravitational pull force is weaker than on Earth. In other words, a person weighing 110 pounds or 50 kilograms on Earth will weigh as little as 18.7 kilograms or 8.15 kilograms on the moon, only one-fifth of what they weigh on Earth. Thanks to this, an average person on the moon could lift a 330-pound or 150-kilogram motorcycle without any problems with one hand. It is for this reason that, while to leave the Earth, giant rockets are required, to leave the moon, only small rockets are needed to give an initial boost. Thanks to that, the astronauts who went to the moon could return to Earth aboard the takeoff module that gave them the boost they needed to leave the weak gravitational force of the moon. This phenomenon arises because the weight of objects depends on two things. On the one hand, mass, and on the other, the force of gravitational attraction. The more mass an object has, the greater its weight, but the weight can also increase if the force of gravitational attraction increases. For example, the gravitational acceleration force on Earth is 9.81 meters per second squared. On the rest of the planets, this force of gravitational attraction changes. Thanks to that, things weigh different on each planet. Do you want to know how much you would weigh on each planet and how much weight you would be able to lift? Mercury. Let's start with Mercury, the closest planet to the Sun. On Mercury, the force of gravity is only 3.7 meters per second squared, being the planet with the weakest force of gravity. An adult weighing 150 pounds or 68 kilograms on Earth would weigh as little as 56.4 pounds or 25.6 kilograms on Mercury. Because of this, if we could walk on the surface of Mercury, we would feel very light. It would be difficult for us to walk because with each stride, our body would rise slightly, losing contact with the ground and therefore unbalancing our center of gravity. Just like astronauts who went to the moon, the people who go to Mercury would also have to walk, taking small jumps. As an extra fact, an ordinary human being is capable of jumping 1.6 feet or 0.5 meters on Earth. But on Mercury, we could jump up to 3.9 feet or 1.2 meters. Also, if we wanted to make the most of our strength, on Mercury we could seamlessly lift objects that would be impossible here on Earth. An untrained adult could lift objects to 154.3 pounds or 70 kilograms on Mercury, about what a compact car engine weighs, or what an average adult weighs on Earth. Imagine lifting your mother or father with one hand. Venus. On Venus, things would be much more similar to the Earth. Venus has a gravitational pull force of 8.87 meters per second squared. As you can see, it is very similar to the Earth. A person weighing 150 pounds or 68 kilograms on Earth would weigh 134.9 pounds or 61.2 kilograms on Venus. However, this figure is misleading, because although our weight will decrease slightly, we will not be lighter on Venus. On the contrary, we will barely be able to move a finger. Even though Venus's gravitational pull force is weaker, the atmosphere is much heavier and denser than on Earth. Have you tried swimming to the bottom of a pool? If you have tried, you'll know that as you get closer to the bottom, the pressure on your body begins to feel more and more. This is because the more you dive, the more significant amount of water is concentrated on top of you. and this water generates pressure on your body. This is exactly what the atmosphere does. Although it may not seem like it, at this moment while you watch this video, you're submerged in an ocean of air. The air you breathe that makes up the atmosphere is a substance that weighs, and that weight is always on you, only you do not realize it because all your life you felt it and your body's used to it. But if we removed all the air from the atmosphere, your body would suddenly begin to swell like a balloon because you would lose pressure. Humans are used to this pressure. If they take it away, we die. This is what's known as atmospheric pressure. The more gas molecules in the air, the heavier it will be, and the heavier it is, the greater the pressure we feel. On Earth, the atmospheric pressure is measured in pascals and bars. The atmospheric pressure on Earth is only 0.00101 bars. While on Venus, the atmospheric pressure is 90 bars, something like diving a kilometer to the bottom of the ocean. Because of this, even if the force of gravitational attraction on Venus is less than on Earth, atmospheric pressure would crush our bodies like tortillas, preventing us from lifting a single finger. Mars. On the red planet, things would be very similar to Mercury, because on Mars, the gravitational pull force is 3.71 meters per second squared. Because of this, a person weighing 150 pounds or 68 kilograms on Earth would weigh 56.6 pounds or 25.7 kilograms on Mars. Pretty much the same as Mercury, except for minor insignificant differences. Mars is much farther from the Sun than Mercury, and Mars has an atmosphere that protects it from solar radiation, unlike Mercury, which has nothing to protect its surface from wind and solar flares. Thanks to this, on Mars, some winds cause large sandstorms, in addition to the length of days being very similar to the Earth. These factors would cause that on Mars, a person would have difficulty lifting objects if they are in an area with a lot of wind. In addition, the low temperatures could bring obstacles to the mobility of people in their spacesuits. But assuming people managed to build cities to protect themselves from sandstorms and wind, a healthy person would be able to lift objects to 155 pounds or 70 kilograms and jump slightly higher than on the Earth, with heights of 4.2 feet or 1.3 meters. Jupiter. We enter the heavyweights. As expected, the giant planet of all also has an immense gravitational pull force of 24.79 meters per second squared. This causes things to weigh much more on Jupiter than on Earth. A 150-pound or 68-kilogram adult would weigh 382.2 pounds on Jupiter, or 173.3 kilograms. This is much more than double what it weighs on Earth. Just that weight on top of us would be enough to keep us anchored to the ground or the surface of a spaceship or space station floating in the clouds of the gas giant. Jupiter's gravitational pull force wouldn't allow us to do many things. Even something as simple as leaping would cost us a lot of work, reaching maximum heights of just 0.6 feet or 0.2 meters. There's no doubt that being under the force of gravity of Jupiter for a long time would be impossible for our bodies. The maximum weight we could lift would be that of our own body, and that with luck. Saturn. Once we've moved away from the crushing force of gravity of Jupiter, we will reach Saturn. In this case, things get calmer, since the force of gravity of Saturn is 10.44 meters per second squared. As you can see, even though Saturn is immensely bigger than the Earth, its gravitational pull force is very similar. This is due to the composition of the planet. Don't forget that the giant planets are made mainly of gas, not rock like the Earth. Rock is much denser and takes up little space, while gas takes up a lot of space and are very light. Because of this, except for Jupiter, the rest of the gaseous planets, although they are larger than the Earth, the force of gravity is not so different. A 150-pound or 68-kilogram adult would weigh as little as 158.9 pounds or 72 kilograms on Saturn. As you can see, the difference would not be so significant, but our weight would increase, so our ability to carry things on top of it, like on the Moon, instead of increasing, would be reduced. The most we could carry would be objects weighing less than 55 pounds or 25 kilograms, such as boxes, tools, or children who need help to move. Uranus. We continue through the gaseous planets and reach Uranus. This planet has a gravitational pull force of 8.87 meters per second squared. Sound familiar? Exactly. What happens is that the force of gravity on Uranus is precisely the same as on Venus. A person weighing 150 pounds or 68 kilograms on Earth would weigh as little as 131.9 pounds or 59 kilograms on Uranus. Thanks to this, our strength would be increased if we were in a spaceship or some floating hotel on the clouds of Uranus. We would feel lighter, being able to jump up to 1.96 feet or 0.6 meters, and lift objects slightly heavier than we can lift on Earth, such as a car tire weighing 68 pounds or 31 kilograms, or heavy tools that on Earth would cost us some lift. Neptune. We reached the farthest and coldest planet of all. On Neptune, the force of gravitational attraction is 11.15 meters second squared. Because of this, someone weighing 150 pounds or 68 kilograms on Earth would weigh 169.4 pounds or 76.8 kilograms on Neptune. The gravitational pull force of Neptune is greater than that on Earth. Because of this, our ability to lift heavy objects would be diminished as we would use some of our strength to hold our extra weight. Because of this, on Neptune, we wouldn't be able to lift anything that weighed more than 48.5 pounds or 22 kilograms, which a travel backpack weighs. In addition, with the extra weight on our body, the maximum height we could jump is 1.31 feet or 0.4 meters. Finally, let's talk about a body that is not a planet but worth mentioning. We'll talk about Pluto, the dwarf planet. On Pluto, the gravitational pull force is only 0.62 meters per second squared. This represents a small fraction of the Earth's gravity. Due to the low gravity of this body, a person weighing 150 pounds or 68 kilograms on Earth would weigh as little as 9.9 pounds or 4.5 kilograms on Pluto. Thanks to this, a person on Pluto could lift objects weighing up to 881 pounds or 400 kilograms. This is more or less what a compact car or cow weighs. In addition, with our lightweight, we could jump up to 25 feet or 7.6 meters. If we compare it with the Earth, it would be like jumping to the height of a two-story house with a single impulse using only our legs. How weight acts on the different planets of the solar system is fascinating. Would you like us to bring more exciting facts about the solar system? Let us know your opinion in the comments.